conceive, believe, achieve. Shut the fuck up.
All right, let's get into this main event, because that is the main event, of course, yeah, for a reason. Colby Covington, I got to say, that press conference was amazing, right? And whether you like Colby or not, right, he did his job. Because I was
what
there.
What do you think
I was
of Colby?
I've never met the guy. I've never had a conversation. We had one famous back and forth on Fox Sports, which was regrettable.
Oh, right. That's right.
I've got nothing against the guy. I've never met him. Some of his shticks, some of his antics, maybe I'm not keen on, but I can't say shit because I used to do the same kind of stuff when I was fighting. Yeah. You know what I mean? And by all accounts, everybody says that it's an act. And if it is, then he does it very well. Because I'm telling you, he sold the shit out of that fight. And when I was there at that press conference, I fucking loved what he did. I love it. He was hilarious. He was entertaining. He was confident. He sold the fight. And I was like, fuck, Colby might just do this, you know?
So when you fought GSP, weren't you frustrated that GSP wasn't selling the fight the way that you were selling the fight?
No,
like, I wasn't. Like, not like frustrated, but like you used to sell the fight. You were great at that.
Yeah.
And then, like, when you don't always have the dance partner to do it, it's like, come on.
But I knew I didn't have the dance partner to do it. So that's why I stepped on it and I did it from that angle. Yeah. I was like, I'll just pick on George. You know what I mean? And that's what I'm going to have to do. Because George is the man. Do you know what I mean?
Well, and his return was a big story in itself.
Yeah.
But then you coming, you know, it was good.
Yeah, I just amplified it and talked shit and made a fool out of myself. But said, hey, listen, you know what I mean? Wouldn't be the first time, won't be the last.
Right. But like to your point where you said like Colby, whether you like him or you hate him, like Colby does, I like Colby. I think that he just does his job so well. You know what I mean?
He does.
Like if you hate him, good. He's doing his job. Like we need people to hate in the sport. Like he decided that was the role he was going to play. And he is playing it to perfection. Like,
because
he's a little cringy. He pushes it too far. Like he does all these things, you know, but it's all in the sake of the entertainment. I like it. I think.
Yeah. No. And listen, as a fan,
it's good for the sport. You know,
when I was sitting there in the press conference, I was loving it. He made that press conference, you know, and God bless everyone else up there on the stand. Cause no one else really got to look it, you know, but it's impossible not to direct the questions to Colby. Number one, when he's dressed like, I don't know what you call that suit, but saved, hey, fair play, color. Fair play. Somewhere out of Miami Vice. And then, you know, he stole the show. He did incredible and he hyped the fight. He did what you needed to do. And for those people that don't know the story, famously, when he went down to Brazil and fought Damian Maia, he was told by his agent, win or lose, the UFC aren't re-signing you for another contract, because that is their right. You are fighting out your contract and they thank you and you will part on your ways. And he thought to himself, shit, I've got to cut a promo that's going to force them to have me. So that's when he called Brazil a dump and called them all rats. And I forget what he said now.
He said, all you filthy animals suck.
Yeah, all you filthy animals suck.
This place is a dump, all you filthy animals.
Yeah, this place is a dump. I wish we had that video. But it was... like, I remember watching that and thinking, oh my God, Colby's going to be lucky to get out of there alive.
Right.
And if this is true and he got signed on the back of it and became this new character, hey, God bless him. God bless him.
Yeah. That was like when I was coming into the UFC. That was like September of 2017. So I hadn't called my first event yet, but you know, whatever. And I'm just like, whoa, isn't that pushing it a little too far type of thing? And that to me is the doctor. Oh,
well done, Brian.
Colby Covington.
DC was right there
you
with him.
You asked for Damian Maia. You got
the DC's
Damian
a wrestling
Maia.
Fan too.
Why did you ask for this fight? And did it go as you expected it to? I should have knocked him out. Brazil, you're a dog. All you filthy animals suck. I got one thing to say. Tyrell Woodley, I'm coming for you. If you don't answer the front door, I'm going to knock in. And I'm going to take what's mine. That one to a belt. Colby.
And then is it Derek the translator?
I don't think Derek translated that. I think the DC just said, you know, let's
Derek's
not going
to translate to all these Brazilian people. By the way, everybody, he said to you that this place is a dump and we are all filthy animals. I don't know why I'm doing a fucking half Dagestani accent. There you go. Whatever. Anyway, let's get into the fight. It was great, right?
It was,
The build-up, it was fantastic. It was sensational. I don't know what it did numbers-wise, but I would assume that the pay-per-view buys were very, very healthy for that, because he's a star, man, and he sold that fantastically, but he's not only a good talker, he's a very, very good fighter. He was the rightful number one contender. I mean, there's a few other people that could lay claim to that, but still, You know, so some people were like, oh, how do you feel about Colby getting that fight? I'm like, well, listen, either way, it's happening. So just deal with it, because I don't think anyone's complaining, because it's a great fight. He fights at an incredible pace. The way I saw it was that he has a higher pace, a higher output, but Kamaru has the knockout power. And I thought that Colby got off to a slow start. I was watching, I thought maybe, because he was out of range a lot. He was throwing shots, but he was out of range. And I think he was concerned about the power of Kamaru, which, of course, you should be, right? Kamaru knocked you out last time you fought, so you've got to be respectful. But I think giving up those first two rounds really cost him, because in round four and five, he really turned on the pressure, and he started having his biggest moments, and he landed some good, powerful shots. But it was a little bit too little too late.
I was nervous through the first 5-10 minutes of that fight. I was like, is this going to be a clunker? It was really slow to start. I guess Usman, knocked him down in the second round, knocked him down twice or whatever in the second round. But that first round was pretty slow. Like, it was pretty slow on both sides. They were really, it was really a chess match. And I was like, oh, don't do this, you know? Certainly Colby came back. I thought you can make a strong case. Colby won round three and four. And then Usman did enough in five. I think also, like, we talked a lot about how Colby sold the fight and I don't want to call him a genius. That's not the right word, but the act that he puts on and playing the heel very, very well. But Usman is starting to sell fights because he's starting to win really impressively, like knockouts in three of his last four. Usman was always a decision guy. Like, I've called his fights to be like, okay, you're going to get a lot of wrestling. You're going to get a lot of top control. Like, he beat Emil Mech in St. Louis at his 30% or whatever. I think he was sick that week.
I remember that.
It was just like, you know, come on, give us something. And as a champion recently, he has destroyed people.
BetterHelp.com/believe, BetterHelp.com/believe, 10% off your first month. Once more, BetterHelp.com/believe for 10% off your first month.